Here I am out in a recently planted wheat field. And you can see the wheat coming up. And one of the things that the Lord's been getting my attention concerning is this concept of process. And I was told once, years ago, that the process is just as important as the end product. And as I thought about that, the person that was talking to me said, "Sean, I can see that you really work hard and strive for that end product, like you persevere and you endure. But I want to challenge you to see the process just as important as the end product." And this was shared with me back in the early 90s by the vice president of Motorola. And I have thought about this and prayed about this over the years. And I have used the words that Paul shared when he says, "I've learned what it's like to be in need and what it's like to have plenty." And he talks about learning the secret of being content in any and every situation. And he goes on to say, "For I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength." So we could look at this wheat field, and I was watching the farmers plant this field on a hike a few weeks ago. And I have continued to walk around this particular section multiple times since then. And we have had a lot of rain. I think this field has had between 6 and 10 inches of rain since they planted. And so it's popped up really quick. I talked to the farmer, he said he's really pleased with that. And the interesting thing is the farmer prepares the field, the farmer plants the seed, and there's this process of praying for rain and hoping for sun, as we have sun out today. And yet when I come back to my own life and think about my attitude about the process, I realize that in general, I naturally don't enjoy the process. And so by God's grace and with His help, I can choose to have a good attitude and I can choose to value the process. Well, it's been over 20 years since I talked with this vice president of Motorola. And recently talked to him again and told him, "Thank you so much for challenging me to enjoy the process, to choose a good attitude about the process, to enjoy the journey." And as I was sharing this, I asked him if he remembered telling me this. And he said, "Yes, I do remember telling you this." And I said, "Any new thoughts?" And he said, "I think I've changed my mind." He said, "I think the process is not equally important as the end product, but," he said, "I think the process is more important than the end product." And we got to talking about the chapter of faith and the heroes of the faith. And I'm challenged with this. I'll take you on the journey with me if you would like to. Let's look to God. God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And let's choose a good attitude. Let's choose joy, and let's allow God to teach us the secret of being content in the process. God bless you.